Hi viewer, I welcome you to the Edin TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through geography form 1, lesson 16. The topic it is statistical methods. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mutham. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson goals. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to understand the definitions. These are the definitions that are used in the topic. Then, identify the types of statistical data. And then, list sources of statistical data. Let us look at the definition. We have the first one, which is statistics. Statistics, it is the facts and figures collected and arranged in a systematic manner. It is very simple. They are facts and figures. We collect them and arrange them in a systematic manner. Then we go to another way that we can define statistics. It is that art or science which is concerned with the interpretation of the numerical information. So my interest is, I interpret whatever that has been given numerically. So that is what is statistics. Statistical data, it refers to the actual facts and figures collected from various areas and arranged in an organized manner. So they are the actual facts now and figures that are collected from various areas and arranged in an organized manner. Then we look at the topic, statistical methods. These are the techniques of collecting, recording, analyzing, presenting, and interpreting statistical data with a view to draw valid and useful conclusions from them. So you can be able to get, we collect, we record, we analyze, we present, and we interpret. That is what is statistical methods, and that is what we'll be dealing with. Let us look at the different types of the data and their sources. There are two types of statistical data. One of them, it is the primary and the secondary. We start by looking at primary data. When we talk about the primary data, these include how the facts and figures collected first and through different methods. We'll be looking at the different methods that we use to collect the data. The data has not been documented, so you don't have any document. You go to the field, collect the data. It can be said it is the original data. It is the original data. You go to the secondary data. It includes all the facts and figures collected and recorded in textbooks, journals, statistical abstracts, or other written materials. So this one, we get it from the books, from the written materials, either from the textbook, journals, census report, statistical abstract. We get the information from there. That is the reason as to why we refer to it as the secondary data. We look at the characteristics of the secondary data. When we talk about the characteristics of the secondary data, there are two. This data can be discrete data. The discrete data, it means that it cannot be given in halves, in decimals, or even in fractions. So you must get it as our. For example, when we are talking about the population of human being, population of the animals, that when we don't have even half, even if that person was born today, that is a person and not half a person. But when I talk about the continuous data, this is the data that shows the continuity. So it is given in decimal point fractions. That is the data like the measurement. 0.2, 2.5, that is what we say it is a continuous data. to and F. What are the sources of the primary data? Now, when we talk about the sources of primary data, there are different methods that we can apply to get the primary data. For example, you have the oral interviews, direct observation, questioning, sampling, taking measurement. All that is under primary data. Sources of the secondary data can be the textbook, statistical abstract, census report, geological report, and also the newspaper. So you can take them with them. We go on to the methods of data collection. And today we are going to look at two of them. Then the others, we are going to look at them later. Questioning. It uses questions to gather information. That is the reason as to why we say filling in of questionnaires. It consists of a list of questions that are related to the topic that is being studied, that is being researched. What are the type of the questions that you can formulate? There are two. It can be personal interview questionnaires and also the rigid questionnaires. So those are the different types of the questionnaires that you can put forward. Then the factors to consider when setting up the questionnaires. One, we start with the simplicity and clarity. The questions should be very simple and clear. Number two, it is the number of questions. They should be as few as possible. Number three, it is the logical order of the questions. We should start with the simplest or following one another to the earnest. Then number four, it is relevance of the question. They should be related to the topic you are studying. Then number five, nature of the questions. Avoid questions that are touching one's life. Just ask open questions. Then finally, it is the objectivity of the questions. They should be able to meet one or two objectives of your topic of study. What are the advantages? One is able to seek clarification of unclear response. Number two, one is able to win the respondent trust and dispel any fear. This is done after getting the answer. You can ask more questions that are not in the questionnaire in order for you to get the clear answer, or even remove the fear that is in that person and it gives you the right answer. Number three, it is that direct contact with the respondent provides the researcher with an opportunity to gauge the accuracy of the answers given. So you're able to get the answers. Number four, comparison can be made because similar questions are used for all the respondents, Then they are source of first hand data. Then rigid questionnaires, when posted to the respondent, to reduce the fieldwork expenses. Then we go to disadvantage. Traveling expenses inflate the resource cost. A lot of time is also lost in the movement. Number three, the questionnaire may not be effective when the respondent is illiterate. Number four, mailed questionnaire usually bring back insincere and inaccurate answers. Finally, questionnaires when mailed may never reach the respondent. We look at the next one, that is the interviews. This is the direct discussion between the researcher and the respondent. When they meet face to face, it direct when they converse through their phone. So you can cut out the interview in two ways. What are the advantages? One is able to seek clarification for the ambiguous responses. One, provide an instant source of information. Number two, they can be used to generate data from illiterate people. Direct contact with a respondent enables one to estimate the accuracy of the data. One is able to dispel fear from the respondent. Then disadvantages, it is time consuming, may be seen as intrusive to the respondent. Language barrier may arise. And finally, it is expensive. Activity defines statistical methods, and then state two types of statistical data. You can get more information from the KRB 2003, book one, student book. You can get us for more information through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook and through the Twitter. Stay tuned to the Adam TV. Thank you.